A production fee was paid to WBBZ-TV from the Erie County Agricultural Society for this special presentation, with sponsorship from Milk for Health and Paula's Donuts. It's time for Fair Day Live, with everything you need to know about the Erie County Fair, with interesting people, places, and events at the Hamburg Fairgrounds. With that and more surprises, here's Liz Mantell.
And welcome to Saturday, everyone. Oh my gosh, we're getting so close to the end of the fair. We've got a great show today. The people protecting you at the fair, the Mounted Division, we're gonna take a visit to see them. We're gonna sample a fair classic fried dough, and we're gonna get to meet the Everly brothers. Them, but not them, the other ones. You'll see what I mean. All right, let's take a look at what's going on today at the fair. We've been talking about this for the entire fair. It's the Firefighter Honoree Ceremony. This is just a fantastic ceremony. It happens 6 p.m. daily outside of the Fireman's Building. Our honoree today is Jason Robinson Sr. It's a fantastic ceremony. The All-Star Fair Band is there. They play three songs. It sounds fantastic. You really should come out and see it before the fair ends. And then at 6:30, we make our way down to Slade Park. This is the Veteran Honoree of the Day, a veteran or an active military member, and then the flag retreat ceremony. Frank Magavero is our honoree tonight, and again, the All-Star Fair Band is there, and it's a really, really great moment to share with everyone at the fair and to honor our veterans. So you can check out that tonight at 6:30, again in Slade Park. In the recruitment spotlight tent today, it's Student Transportation of America. You can find that tent right across from the WBBZ gazebo, so when you go to spin the wheel, you can go and check out that recruitment spotlight tent as well. The smoke dance competition starts today at 2 p.m. in the Niaway Indian Village. That's always fun to watch. And then the live auction starts today at 3 p.m. in the Showplex. Now, this is if you're interested in buying any of the animals that maybe you've walked around seeing during the 4-H barns. Great way to support the local 4-H kids. If you're not sure how an auction works, great news. Show up to the Showplex at 2 p.m. It's their social hour. You're going to get to meet former buyers. Staff from the fair are going to be there, and they can kind of explain the process for you. So again, even if you don't want to buy a pig, a cow, or a sheep, you should go check out that auction. It's a really fun time, and you get to see the kids really getting paid for their hard work. Literally getting paid. All right, tonight is the ultimate night of destruction. It's in the Buffalo News grandstand, and it is at 7:30. You can still get tickets right now at ecfair.org. Speaking of tickets, admission tickets for adults, $13.50 every day if you buy them online at ecfair.org. No extra fees when you buy them online. Kids 12 and under, they get in free every single day. But if you wait to buy your tickets at the gate, which you certainly can do, they are $15, and you can only buy them with a credit card. But just like all 12 days, free parking at the fair. And you can always find out what's going on at the fair. It's very overwhelming when you come. There's a lot to do. Get your daily schedule, ecfair.org, or download the Fairgrounds mobile app, which is powered by the New York Lottery. And if you have a ticket for any of the grandstand shows during the fair, that does act as your ticket during the fair. So you can come in, use that ticket that you got for the show that night at the fair. Okay, are you ready for this? This was really, really cool to see. You know, we all have these visions of mounted sheriffs and people on horses, but then to actually get to see what they do here at the fair and protect us every day was just awesome. We had a chance to catch up. Let's take a look.
Okay, here at the Erie County Fair, safety is one of the top priorities, but this is pretty unique. The Erie County Mounted Division. I should say the Erie County Fair Mounted Division.
Yes, yes.
The fair has their own mounted division. We have Captain Hobson with us here. Explain a little bit about what the mounted division does here.
We're the first eyes and ears of the fair. We travel the perimeter of the fair every night, 4 to 12, sometimes earlier if we're asked to. It depends on how busy the days are. But yes, we are to see and report things that we make us uncomfortable or something might not be right. And we have a security, we have law enforcement, state troopers, sheriffs, border patrol on site all the time. So.
And right now we're witnessing something that happens every night. This is how you guys get started, right?
Yes, every day at 4 o'clock we line up right here, and I go through a couple of things with my team, dismount and mount, and it's basically for a show for the audience. You know, I have a good audience here every day. So.
And this happens every day outside of the mounted security barn.
Yes, every day at 4 o'clock. We're right here, and I address my team for a second, and then we go out and begin our day.
So what does it take to be a part of the mounted division here?
Well, I have a couple trainings a year in June and July. It's all day here on Sunday, right here at the fairgrounds. And it's quite extensive. I set up about 40 obstacles, and my team goes through that. If I have to have a hiring, you know, even though you've been here 5, 10, 15 years, you got to make it through these trainings every summer before we get to the fair, because there's a lot of things every year that could spook the horse or whatever.
And are these all their own horses?
These are all their own horses, yes.
So checklist number one, you have to have a horse.
Yes, you have to have a horse, and I have lots of experience riding it, absolutely.
All yes. Right, so a typical day, they get here, you get mounted up, and literally just roaming
yes.
the grounds.
Yes, every night we make circles, and sometimes it ends up being 12, 13, 14 miles.
Really?
Evening. Yes, yep, every evening. So these horses are in the heat, and they're going, and we make sure they got water, you know, at all times, and
let's say we're walking around the fairgrounds, right, and we see some horses coming our way. Can people come up and interact with the horses?
Absolutely, I encourage that. There's a lot of, you know, every day I riding here for 24 years, I get people that have never touched a horse, smell the horse. I always tell them, touch them on the nose and then smell their hand, and they're like, oh boy, that really smells cool. So, yeah. So,
I would say I love that about the fair. So many, it's such a diverse population that comes, and they get to experience things that normally they never would.
Yes, yes, absolutely.
All right. Now, the Erie County Fair is known for some pretty unique things, being the first. Are there other fairs that have this, or is this unique to Erie County?
Yes, there is. There's quite a few fairs across the country that has a mounted security, probably not as big as ours, but we do a great job for Jessica. We really thrive to do a great job for everyone that's involved in the security here at the fairgrounds.
And you were telling me this is only half of your division.
Yes, this is half the crew. We work every day, like I said, 4 to 12, but this was a special day for us to be, you know, filmed by some crews, so we got all dressed up early, and yeah, everybody's in support of that for sure.
Well, we thank you for doing that, and we thank you for doing what you guys do every day, and make sure if you guys see them, you are allowed to ask. Don't just run up to the horse. Ask. We are allowed to touch the horse and thank them for their service as well. Thank you so much. Thank you to all of you, and can't wait to see you roaming around the fair.
All right. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thanks to the great men and women of the Mounted Division. All right, when we come back, we're sampling a fair classic that has a great history with the Erie County Fair, right after this.
Fair Day Live continues after this.
Paula's Donuts is now open in Larkinville, 872 Seneca Street. Try our delicious new deli sandwiches, turkey, ham, BLTs on white, whole wheat, 9-grain, or jalapeno cornbread. Come and take a picture with Donut Girl. Open 7 days a week, 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Paula's Donuts now open in Larkinville.
Get ready for a roaring good time at the 182nd Erie County Fair, August 10th through the 21st. Amazing animals, thrilling rides, fabulous food, and super shows. The best 12 days of summer are here again. Visit ecfair.org for daily schedules, tickets, and more for the Erie County Fair in Hamburg, New York.
Our dedication to quality grows every day. We rise before the sun, take care of our own, and spend our days making great tasting milk. Milk we're proud of. Because out here, we're committed to helping you achieve what's in here. A happier, healthier home, where our quality is measured in family time. We are Upstate Farms, a family of over 360 local dairy farmers, and milk is our life's work.
How do plastic bottles turn into this? WM and Reprieve have given new life to over 20 billion plastic bottles. And we're just getting started. See how recycling is one of the many ways WM is always working for a sustainable tomorrow at wm.com/stories.
Paula's Donuts is now open in Larkinville, 872 Seneca Street. Try our delicious new deli sandwiches. Turkey, ham, BLTs on white, whole wheat, nine-grainer, jalapeno cornbread. Come and take a picture with Donut Girl. Open 7 days a week, 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Paula's Donuts now open in Larkinville.
Welcome back to Fair Day Live.
All right, if you were to ask about just one of the iconic staples here at the Erie County Fair when it came to food, I think we'd hands down have to say fried dough. And it's a tradition that started years ago with a hometown vendor. We were able to catch up with them and get a taste. All right, you know that I love food and we talk about the new food, but let's talk about the classic fair food, and that is the fried dough. We have Kelly Grout from Jack's Fries and Tootsie's Fried Dough. Thank you so much for coming today.
Good morning.
All right, so you're literally all over the fair. You have a Jack's Fries, and then you also have four Tootsie's Fried Dough. So literally, wherever you are in the fair, you're going to have an opportunity to grab one of these.
Absolutely.
All right, so let's talk. Why is fried dough such a classic fair staple?
It's been around since the early 70s. It's just a staple food item.
And did your family have something to do with that?
We started here at the Erie County Fair back in, I believe, the early 70s. I don't remember the exact date. And they just fell in love with it here. And Dad added a trailer every couple years. And
so you kind of introduced fried dough to the Erie County Fair?
Yeah, I would say Dad did, yeah.
Well, that's awesome. Yeah. And you've been coming ever since?
Yes.
That's incredible. Since the 70s.
Yep.
That's incredible. You know, we talk about it all the time. The fair is like family. And the fact that you've been coming since the 70s, I mean, so you must really know the fair like the back of your hand.
I've grown up here. My daughters have grown up here. It's just, we look forward to coming here. It's a family fair.
Oh, I absolutely love that. All right. So can you tell me the difference between fried dough and, let's say, a funnel cake?
Fried dough is a sweet bread dough. It's pulled. And funnel cake is more like a sweet pancake batter that's poured through a funnel.
Okay, so there is a slight difference to
yes.
it. Wouldn't you know that I have a fork and knife? I know that probably shocks you that I am prepared for some food. So we have a classic. This is just with
yep.
the powdered dough.
Just with the powdered sugar. Yeah.
And then what do we have on top of
this
here?
This one's got a little bit of strawberry topping on it.
Oh, okay. Let's try that one. Strawberry is one of my favorite flavors. So what? How fast can you crank these out? Because I assume that you've got a good line going every day.
Oh, sure.
How long does it take to make one of these?
About 3 minutes, start to finish.
Oh, okay. All right. I mean, it tastes like the fair. It's a classic. I absolutely love it. All right, so, caught me again. I'm eating. All right, so we've got the fried dough, and we've got the fries. You told me earlier off camera that you travel around the country doing this.
Yes. Yep.
How many fairs do you hit?
Seven.
Seven fairs, and then in the off season, you go to conventions as well.
Yeah, convention season starts is what we call it, but yeah.
So do you ever in the back when you're alone and you're like, how could I really jazz this up? Do you ever get crazy and try out new recipes?
We do try new toppings and stuff like that. I try to keep the fried dough a classic the way it is. I mean, it's been a staple. I don't want to change it too much. And you expect a certain product when we
right.
come here, and I don't want to mess with it.
Is this the one that sells the most, the classic with the
sure.
with the powdered sugar on it?
Yeah.
All right, tell us a little bit about your fry stand. Is it just straight fries?
No, we do fresh cut fries. We do what we call a Millennium chip, which is a homemade pulled chip. We have fresh hand dipped corn dogs.
Hand dipped corn dogs?
Sure.
Ooh, that's a fair classic. Well, you're really sticking to the classics. I like that.
Yeah.
All right, so let's talk about your locations at the fair. Where is Jack's Fries?
Right on the Avenue of Flags.
Right at the top of the Avenue of Flags. And where are your four locations for the fried dough?
I have one at the top of the old gaming center. I have one at Gate 5. One at Gate 4 and one on Broadway.
I absolutely love it. Do you see, so you've been coming to the fair every year. I know that you're probably busy, you know, cranking out the fried dough and the fries, but do you have a favorite part of the fair?
Personally, I like strolling through the buildings.
Yeah, seeing everything, right?
Yeah.
And now you've been coming for so long. Do you see regulars coming back every year for fried dough?
Do
you recognize
I
people?
Do. Yeah.
Oh, I absolutely.
And I have people that come up every year. I come to this one stand because this one's the best.
Oh, I love it. That's what happens here at the Erie County Fair. All right, I'm going to keep eating this. Thank you so much for bringing this. Kelly Grout, you've got everywhere. Literally, if you go everywhere on the fairgrounds, you're going to be able to get some fried dough. And I'm telling you to get the fried dough. I like the strawberry one. I should probably try this one, though. Just, you know, because I have to report back the truce over here. But again, another classic when we come to the fair. This just, to me, it tastes like the fair, and that's what's important. Mm-mm-mm. It's delicious. Make sure you try it out. Kelly, thank you for coming in.
Thank you for having me.
All right, thank you, Kelly, to you and your family for creating this fair food tradition. Coming up next, we meet the Everly set.
Fair Day Live continues after this.
Paul's Donuts is now open in Larkinville, 872 Seneca Street. Try our delicious new deli sandwiches, turkey, ham, BLTs on white, whole wheat, nine-grainer, jalapeno cornbread. Come and take a picture with Donut Girl. Open 7 days a week, 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Paul's Donuts now open in Larkinville.
Get ready for a roaring good time at the 182nd Erie County Fair, August 10th through the 21st. Amazing animals. Thrilling rides. Fabulous food. And super shows. The best 12 days of summer are here again. Visit ecfair.org for daily schedules, tickets, and more for the Erie County Fair in Hamburg, New York.
Our dedication to quality grows every day. We rise before the sun, take care of our own, and spend our days making great tasting milk. Milk we're proud of. Because out here, we're committed to helping you achieve what's in here. A happier, healthier home, where our quality is measured in family time. We are Upstate Farms, a family of over 360 local dairy farmers, and milk is our life's work.
How do plastic bottles turn into this? WM and Reprieve have given new life to over 20 billion plastic bottles. And we're just getting started. See how recycling is one of the many ways WM is always working for a sustainable tomorrow at WM.com/stories.
Paul's Donuts is now open in Larkinville, 872 Seneca Street. Try our delicious new deli sandwiches, turkey, ham, BLTs on white, whole wheat, nine-grainer, jalapeno cornbread. Come and take a picture with Donut Girl. Open 7 days a week, 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Paul's Donuts now open in Larkinville.
Welcome back to Fair Day Live.
All right, welcome back to Fair Day Live. One of the things that you love about the fair is you're walking around and there's always entertainment. Now, let's travel back in time just a little bit. The Everly Brothers, they were a kind of a rock duo that really kind of pioneered the country rock movement. Let's catch you up. Let's take a look really quick at the Everly Brothers.
Wake up, it is Susie. Wake up.
How about that? And the Everly Brothers are here with us at the Erie County Fair, kind of reincarnated as the Everly set with daily performances at the Family Entertainment Complex. I had a chance to catch up with them after one of their shows.
Okay, so one of the great things about the Erie County Fair, in addition to the food and the fun and the fireworks, it's the free entertainment, and there is a ton of it. And right now we are with Sean and Jack, also known as the Everly set. Good afternoon, guys.
Hey, Liz.
Good afternoon.
Nice to be here.
Thanks for having us.
Let's start with this. Obviously, the Everly set. What kind of music are you guys playing?
We are the definitive Everly Brothers tribute act, celebrating the music of Phil and Don Everly, Bye Bye Love, Wake Up Little Susie, All I Have to Do Is Dream, Let It Be Me, Bird Dog, so many amazing classic hits.
So you're going to know the songs. You're going to be able to sing along. All right, so we're at the family event stage. I think I got that name right. When are your show times every day?
We're on at 12 p.m., 3 p.m., and 6 p.m. every day.
Awesome. Make sure you come and check them out. So what kind of, obviously you must be fans of the Everly Brothers, but what got you into the life of a traveling musician?
We grew up on this music. You know, we've always been drawn to the music, and we never thought that it would be a formal act where we get to travel the country and so many people would want to hear us do it. But we started it for fun, and it's a great privilege to be able to play in theaters and fairs all around the country, for sure.
So you really do, you travel the country. Is this a year-round thing, or do you guys have, is this your day job, I guess I should say?
This is one of our day jobs. In fact, we have two acts. We have the Everly set and another tribute, Forever Simon and Garfunkel. So between the two acts, you know, we've got 100 theater dates coming up, so very busy.
What's it like to be able to look out into the crowd and see people singing back to you? I mean, obviously they know the music from growing up on it, but that still has to be an incredible feeling.
It's a great honor to be able to elicit that kind of response from people. You can see that a lot of the audience grew up with this music. They know the words. They dance to it at their prom. And even the younger kids, they relate to the music too. And we see them dancing in the aisles. It's been great fun.
Awesome. All right. So obviously you guys play this. Do you dabble in your own music? Do you guys find yourself writing music when you're on the road?
We are actually both acclaimed songwriters. Jack, in fact, is the winner of the Songwriters Hall of Fame Buddy Holly Prize in Songwriting. Right. And I am the, believe it or not, I wrote the Where in the World is Carmen Sandiego theme song.
Stop right now. Stop. You, that was you?
Yes, I wrote that. I was the leader of Rockapella. So that's the beauty of this, is that we're both songwriters and we came to this music because we love their songs.
I'm having like this moment right now. You were in Rockapella. You were on the show that I watched all the time and you wrote that song. Are you kidding? Oh my gosh, I'm having a moment. Oh, I have, hold on, let me fangirl her for a moment. That was my childhood. That is so awesome. Thank you.
Behold my glory.
Oh my God, thank you so much. This is amazing. All right, so I need a moment. While I do that, will you guys sing a little something for us?
Sure, here we go. Okay.
All right, it doesn't happen often, but I did have a bit of a fangirl moment. I grew up on that show. It was a real treat, I will say that. All right, coming up next, we're wrapping up today's show. Stick around.
Fair Day Live continues after this.
Paula's Donuts is now open in Larkinville, 872 Seneca Street. Try our delicious new deli sandwiches, turkey, ham, BLTs on white, whole wheat, 9-grain, or jalapeno cornbread. Come and take a picture with Donut Girl. Open 7 days a week, 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Paula's Donuts now open in Larkinville.
Get ready for a roaring good time at the 182nd Erie County Fair, August 10th through the 21st. Amazing animals. Thrilling rides. Fabulous food. And super shows. The best 12 days of summer are here again. Visit ecfair.org for daily schedules, tickets, and more for the Erie County Fair in Hamburg, New York.
Our dedication to quality grows every day. We rise before the sun, take care of our own, and spend our days making great tasting milk. Milk we're proud of. Because out here, we're committed to helping you achieve what's in here. A happier, healthier home, where our quality is measured in family time. We are Upstate Farms, a family of over 360 local dairy farmers, and milk is our life's work.
How do plastic bottles turn into this? WM and Reprieve have given new life to over 20 billion plastic bottles.
And we're just getting started.
See how recycling is one of the many ways WM is always working for a sustainable tomorrow at WM.com/stories.
Paula's Donuts is now open in Larkinville, 872 Seneca Street. Try our delicious new deli sandwiches. Turkey, ham, BLTs on white, whole wheat, 9-grain, or jalapeno cornbread. Come and take a picture with Donut Girl. Open 7 days a week, 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Paula's Donuts now open in Larkinville.
Welcome back to Fair Day Live.
All right, welcome back. Let's get a rundown of what's going on today at the fair. All right, we've got the firefighter honoree of the day, Jason Robinson Sr. That takes place outside the Fireman's Building for the firefighter honoree ceremony, 6 p.m. The All-Star Fair Band is going to be there as well. So it really is a great ceremony. If you haven't seen it yet, stop on out. Flag retreat ceremony and veteran honoree of the day, Movagaro. I'm sorry, sir. I will get it right for your honoree ceremony. That happens at 6:30 in Slade Park. Also, the All-Star Fair Band is going to be there. It really is a fantastic and moving ceremony, so come on out to honor Frank. In the recruitment spotlight tent, it's the Student Transportation of America. That tent is right across from the WBBZ gazebo, so when you go to spin the wheel, you can stop and check out what they have to offer. Smoke dance competition starts at 2 p.m. in Neoway Indian Village, and the livestock auction, 3 p.m. in the Showplex. But don't forget, if you want to go and just watch, you're a little nervous, you might want to be involved in it, go for their social hour at 2 p.m. You can meet with people who have bought before, the 4-H kids, and, of course, the staff, and they'll kind of give you a rundown of how it works. It's the ultimate night of destruction tonight in the Buffalo News Grandstand. That starts at 7:30 p.m., and tickets are still available at ecfair.org. All right, and as always, if you're coming to the fair, get your tickets online at ecfair.org. There are no extra fees, $13.50 if you buy them online. Kids 12 and under, free admission every day. Now, if you do wait to buy your tickets at the gate, that's cool. You can do it, $15 with a credit card only. And back again is the free parking. Enjoy that. All right, find the latest daily schedules. There's a lot going on when you come to the fair, and it's all there at ecfair.org. Or even better yet, you can download the Fairgrounds mobile app that is powered by the New York State Lottery. They'll show you everywhere on the fairgrounds, all the events that are going on. And did I mention they have a map? That one's also really good. All right, if you have tickets for a grandstand show, if you purchase them in advance, they include a free admission to the fair on the day of the show, and that's really what you get. All right, tomorrow it is our last show. I can't believe it. The fair is almost over. 10:30 tomorrow you can watch on the Erie County Fair Facebook page, and of course, WBBZ-TV. We'll see you tomorrow.
A production fee was paid to WBBZ-TV from the Erie County Agricultural Society for this special presentation, with sponsorship from Milk for Health and Paula's Donuts.